that's wrong. Does that mean it's time for one of my long, boring stories? Yes, please. So when I was like, I think I was 10. I really wanted this bicycle. Like, I really wanted this bicycle. And we had the Canadian Tire catalog. And I used to just flip through it, and I'd go to the part where this bike was. And, you know, I'd like purposely leave it open so when people were walking by, they'd see it. Because my birthday was coming up. But I knew we couldn't afford it. I knew my family couldn't afford it. But I was dreaming about it. And then one day, I think it was about 4 days before my birthday, my uncle comes up to me and he says, "Hey, I have to go to Canadian Tire. Do you want to come with me?" I said, sure, because I used to hang out with my uncle a lot. Like, a lot. We spent a lot of time together. So we went to Canadian Tire. And I can't even remember what he was looking for. But eventually we wound up at the bikes. And I walked by. And I saw the bike I wanted. Was yellow. I never would have thought I wanted a yellow bike. But it looked so cool. It looked like the 10 speeds that were out. And I couldn't afford a 10 speed. I couldn't even afford the 3 speed. But it was cheaper. And it looked like the other bikes. And I really wanted it. So we're there. And my uncle sees me looking at it. And he says, "You really like that bike, don't you?" I said, "Yeah, I love that bike." And he said, "Well, happy birthday, that's your bike now." And I just stood there in shock, like, what? And the salesman came over, and he said, "We're taking." And he had a pickup truck, and we put it in the back. And we drove home. And he took it out of the back of the truck, and he said, "There's your bike." I was the happiest kid ever. So I rode the bike for about a year. And then I got the crazy idea to start doing things to it. All the kids. kids in my neighborhood were taking forks off other bikes and cutting off the tips of the original forks and putting the other ones on it so it looked like a chopper. Everybody was riding around with like these chopper bikes. So I decided to do the same. So I found an old junk bike. But while I was watching what all the other kids were doing, they were putting the forks on, going the same direction as the original forks. So it was one long rake. It was like this long, they all went the same direction. But what wound up happening is it was a weak design. So where the bend was, where the other forks connected, it would bend and bend and bend, and then it would snap. So my idea was to put them on the other way. Instead of having them go the same direction and go like a rake, I did mine going the other way. Was like an S. So I put them on, and I even drilled holes and put bolts in them. And it was really strong, and I rode it like that for a long time, and everybody I knew thought it was so cool that my forks were going the other way. And I put this small little wheel on the front, so it looked kind of like this crazy chopper thing. Wasn't good enough, because eventually what I had to do is I needed to paint it. So I went back to Canadian Tire and I got silver spray paint and I painted it all silver, and then I put all these crazy markings on it and everything. And when I was done, bike in the neighborhood. I rode it like that for a long time. It was a good memory. It was fun riding down the street. Just the wind blowing through your hair. Just one of those memories, you know, makes you smile. I should go on a picnic soon. We'll pick a spot. Bring a basket.